In this final recording, I'm going to review the final elements, the elements that are needed to finish up the project. Since the last recording, I have added more selections to the elephant to make it a little bit more complete. It may not be entirely complete at this point, but enough is done that I'm going to try to show you what you need to do to finalize the project. The first thing I want to call to your attention is I would like you to replace the background, and I chose this image to use as a new background to my elephant. And so I have actually already added it to this project, and I'm just going to turn it on, and I labeled it as scene. So now I have all the elements together in my layers that I want to use for this project. I did notice that the ear in this case looked to me like it was a little darker and didn't blend with the rest of the body elements of this elephant. So I might use the ear as a way to begin to lighten it up to match the rest of those elements. And I'm going to do that with an adjustment layer. So I've selected the ear layer. And I'm just going to choose an adjustment layer like levels. And I'm going to start moving in the highlights and shadows to clip it. But when I do this, I begin to notice that all of the layers are being affected, not just the ear, which I want to change. So I'm going to go back to this levels. I'll just close that properties panel. It opened up as a result of me just selecting the adjustment layer. I didn't do anything else to cause that. And I notice that this levels adjustment layer covers up all the layers below, so it's affecting all those layers. And since I don't want to do that, I'm just going to throw this one away. If I hold down the command or on a PC, the control key and click on the layer called the ear in this case, I can activate a selection that fits around the shape of the ear that I have. I'm going to now choose the adjustment layer, and I can choose an adjustment layer either from the adjustments panel or from the black and white circle on the layers menu, and I'm going to choose levels again. And this time I'm going to clip the highlights, and I can see that the ear is changing and becoming lighter without it affecting the rest of the body. So I'm just going to close the properties panel and accept that selection. Now I want to start looking at a way that I can start grouping layers together logically. And you could start doing groups even beforehand. So I'm going to select the top group here because everything between the head and the eye is everything to do with the head. So I'm going to highlight by shift-clicking this group of layers, and I'm going to create a new group from layers and call it the head. You can also create a group by just clicking on the little group icon here at the bottom of the layers panel. You can drag this wherever you want it. And then I, in this case, want to select the group that has to do with the back or the stomach. And I'll select this whole group. Oops, I have a stomach down here and a leg in the middle. I'm going to move this leg down below the stomach because it is underneath it. And then I'm going to choose all of the layers that have to do with the back and the stomach and drag them into this group. And now I'm going to double click on the group one name and call it body. Now one other thing I haven't added yet is a type layer. So I'm going to select the type tool and I'm going to call this. Right now, what by default, I apparently had selected Futura Gold Bold Oblique 60 point. I might end up changing that, but right now I'm going to call this Tool Elephant. Now, I just started typing the type layer right here, and it entered a layer just above the word body. Now, let's say I don't want to keep that so in that spot, but right now I'm going to click the check mark, and I'm just going to drag type up to the top of the layer. And I want to use this particular type layer. I'm going to add a layer style to this type layer. And I'm going to choose that from the FX menu, and I'm just going to do a drop shadow for now. And I can move this over, and I can move over the image a little bit. Oh, wait, I'm going to cancel this for just a minute. Close this and not save that background layer. And I want to move this in a little bit bigger so I can see it better. And I will now choose the layer style, drop shadow. I can see it a little bit better here. I can move outside this frame that's for the drop shadow and move this around. I can move the size a little bigger or smaller if I want it. I can cause the spread to be a little bit more. I'm dragging this tool back and forth. I think I'll come back to the size. I want it to look a little bit softer. And what I was doing before is I was moving the distance when I dragged outside here, so you can see how the distance moves around as I drag this drop shadow around. When I'm satisfied, I can click OK. And now one other thing that I need to add to this project to make it more complete are the layer comps. So I'm going to go up to the word window and choose layer comps. And I have all these elements now grouped together, and I'm going to create a new layer comp by clicking this. I'm going to make sure that visibility, position, and appearance layer style are all selected. I have a layer style here, and if I want to include, make sure it's included as part of the comp, I need to make sure all this is selected. I'm going to call this my comp one with type, just to make a distinguishable difference. Let's say I decide I want to turn off the layer style. I could create a new comp and call this comp one without style. Maybe I would want to make one without the background scene on it, and I'll create one that says comp one without background, and click OK. So now, what do these layer styles do? By clicking on this one, I see the complete group of elements that I created. In this one, I took off the style, and on this one, I took off the background. So I've done some variations here. If I'd had a second background image I want to use, maybe I could have added it to the stack and had a comp that shows the comp with a different background other than the one without a background, because I don't consider the original background a good choice. Or I could have made some other changes. For example, I still might want to add a tail to this. I could look at the warp tool to warp the trunk or the tusks to make them look a little bit more curvature, but those are not requirements for this project, so I'm not going to go through that at this time. So I hope that gives you enough of an idea of what is needed to complete the project, and I wish you luck with yours.